3 months on since Russia's invasion of Ukraine, more and more civilians are being killed and injured in attacks. Australian entrepreneur James Spenceley is this morning a man on a mission in Ukraine to deliver crowd-funded ambulances kitted out with medical supplies to those in need. And we're pleased to say James joins us now. James, nice to see you. I'm just going to back it up a little bit because I know here you were, you're sitting at home in Sydney, you're the chairman of Airtasker. How did this idea come about? I need to do more for the people of Ukraine.
Well, my wife's Ukrainian. Her family's over here. They're in Russian-occupied areas now, and I spent a couple of years living over here. So it was close to my heart, and I couldn't find a way to actually help. You know, there's big organisations, big aid organisations, but I wanted to directly help. So I thought about buying two ambulances, found some ambulances, and opened it up to friends and family, and it just sort of took off from there. And we've now raised, I think, about $180,000, and we're hoping to get another 10 ambulances, so we're hoping to keep going.
Well, James, as you know, we've been talking to you in the lead-up to this. It's taken months of planning. Now that you're finally there in Ukraine, just tell us what the last couple of days have been like.
Yeah, I mean, it's stressful. You know, we've driven past tanks, you know, going the other direction, you know, fires on the horizons, fighter jets flying over us. Today, we're actually out at Bucha and Irpin, which are two of the hardest hit areas, you know, speaking to the head of medicine at one of the hospitals and finding out what we can do. So it's super stressful, but, you know, we're doing something amazing here. And, you know, we just see everywhere we go, there's more demand than we even thought. There's more damage than we thought. You know, there's huge help needed all across Ukraine.
And James, as you know, we applaud everything that you're over there doing. I mean, what has the reaction been to from people when they see why you're there and what you're doing?
Yeah, a little bit of disbelief. You know, I don't expect an Australian to be here. That's the surprise. But I think we sort of tell them that's what Aussies do. So we've had interviews with Kyiv TV here. You know, they're loving it. It's just a great story. Everyone we meet, it just lifts them up a bit. They really feel that the world's with them. But when someone from as far away as Australia is next to them, they really appreciate it.
Yeah, I mean, you're in the capital there. You're in Kyiv. Do you feel safe?
Yeah, look, we're very lucky. I've got the guys at GM Risk who do all the work for a lot of reporters here. They're helping us out with security and just intelligence. And we were out. It was a hell of a lot of damage around us in the outskirts of Kyiv. As I say, we had fighter jets over us, all those sort of things. So you're not going to. I mean, the worst thing is the air sirens. You know, at 2 a.m. in the morning. You're never going to get used to being woken up with an air siren, but. Yeah, look, we feel as safe as we can be and we're being as careful as possible, but we've still got a few hundred Ks to go to deliver the first ambulances, and we're just taking it slowly and carefully.
Well done. You're doing amazing work, and I know it's appreciated. Thanks for joining us this morning, James.